Good morning, children. I am Ruchika, your English teacher. Children, today, let's do chapter number 16 of your language book, Direct and Indirect Speech. What is direct or an indirect speech? And what is reported speech? Both are one of the same things. When the exact words used by a speaker are reproduced, it is called direct speech. When the meaning of a speech is conveyed in the reporter's words, it is called indirect speech. Children, when the exact words of a speaker are reproduced, the entire speech is put within inverted commas, and this speech is called reported speech. The verb said, S-A-I-D, which introduces the reported speech, is called reporting verb. Usually, a comma or a colon separates the reported speech from the reported verb. For example, the inspector said, I am glad to be with you today, full stop and commas off. S-A-I-D, said is reporting verb. And I am glad to be with you today, in inverted commas, is reported speech. Is it clear to you, children? Direct speech is when the exact words used by a speaker are reproduced, that is direct speech. And when the meaning of a speech is conveyed in the reporter's words, it is called indirect speech. Clear? S-A-I-D is reporting verb, and the sentence given in inverted commas, that is reported speech. I hope it is clear, children. If we compare the direct and indirect forms of narration, we find these points of difference. Means, what is the difference between direct and indirect speech? The direct speech is always within inverted commas. Clear? It is always within inverted commas. It is separated from the rest of the sentence, usually by a comma. No inverted commas are used in the indirect speech. These are the first difference. Okay? Second is, in the indirect speech, a conjunction is used to join the reported speech with the rest of the sentence. What is that conjunction? Conjunction, that is that. Renu said that she was very hungry. Third is, tenses, personal pronouns are I, we, you, etc. Possessive adjectives, my, our, your, etc. and adverbs denoting nearness of time and place undergo certain changes when the direct speech is changed into indirect speech. The inspector said, I am glad to be with you today. The inspector said that he was glad to be with us that day. Children must remember that the inspector said, I am glad to be with you today, that is inverted comma. This is direct speech. The inspector said that he was glad to be with us that day, used with conjunction, that is indirect speech. Is it clear? Now let us see the rules for the change of tenses. If the reporting verb is in present tense or future tense, the tense of the verb in the reported speech remains unchanged. Ashu says, says means it is simple present tense. Ashu says, Pammi is going to England. That is direct speech. If you change direct into indirect, Ashu says that Pammi is going to England. There is no change in it, no change in reported speech. Why? Because says in is given there. Means this sentence is in simple present tense. If the reporting verb is in past tense, the tenses in reported speech are changed into corresponding past tense. Is MR changed into was were, was were changed into had been changed into had been, means no change at all, the same. Simple present tense changes into simple past tense. Do is there, if first form is there, first form changes into second form, and second form changes into had done. Did change to had done, second form changes into had plus third form. Has, have, had changes into had. Then will, shall change into would. In certain cases, shall might be changed to should. May change into might, can into could.
would, should, might, could, ought to, used to, there is no change in it. Same. Must change into had. I'm giving one example to you. Suresh said Anuj is very successful. Suresh said that Anuj was very successful. Here is changed into was. Clear? It is in past tense. If said is given, then it means this sentence is in past tense. And if the sentence is in present or future tense, no change in reported speech. Clear? You must learn these rules, children, of past tense. Learn it properly. Exceptions are: if the reported speech expresses a universal truth or a habitual fact, its tenses remain unchanged. If universal truth is given, then don't change the tense. My father said, too many cooks spoil the broth. The reported speech is in a universal truth. My father said that too many cooks spoil the broth. If the reported speech describes a state of affairs which still exists when the speech is reported, its tense remains unchanged. He said Uma wants to become rich by winning a lottery. Children, the reported speech makes a statement which remains true when the speech is reported. He said that Uma wants to become rich by winning a lottery. Unchanged. If the reported speech contains a time clause, its tense remains unchanged. The main verb of such a sentence can either remain unchanged or become past perfect. He said, when Anu was living in Mumbai, she often saw Som. She said that when Anu was living in Mumbai, she often saw Som. Children, that's all for today. Read page number 130, 131 and 132 and do exercise number 1 in your book. Okay? And learn all the rules properly. And we will continue this topic in the next lecture also. Thank you. Have a nice day.